Dickey, the road to the championship's become a little less crowded, but there still isn't enough room for both of these teams. Which team will become a casualty of the second round in this game between the Hofstra Pride and the Penn State Nittany Lions? This is where both teams wanted to be, Dick. Let's not wait any longer to get this one started. The Nittany Lions are looking at a very tough opponent, Dick. What have they got to do to win?
Hey, they've got to do the following things if they want to be successful. First, work the ball to the interior to your post players. Let that be your option number one offensively. Second of all, make sure you take care of the rock. Turnovers kill momentum. Thirdly, be aggressive defensively. Don't give them any open looks.
Well, partner, I say let's get to the action on the court and we'll see how this one plays out. Didn't like what he saw on the post and reverses the ball. From left of the circle, knocks it down.
Coach looks on, focused, a lot of intensity, a lot of emotion.
He's going to muscle it on the inside.
What an explosive move to the goal. No wasted time. He had his mind made up. He was attacking the basket.
They work the perimeter. Number two takes the pass. For two, and he scores it off the glass. Working it around the perimeter. Number three takes the feed.
That was a high post screen. Goes to the lane.
Inside. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
It's good.
How about an instant replay?
Now they're into it. That's got some people out of their seats.
Hey, that reaction says it all. These fans are ecstatic, Brad.
On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. There's a double team waiting there. Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
Trying to pack it inside.
Double team now, bad angle.
And the ball goes out of play. You talk about a packed house. Look at this crowd.
I tell you, coach's dream, baby. This gives you that edge.
Fed the low block. Great steal. I think the pressure was just too much.
Tremendous pressure. Just enough to force the steal.
Inside. Pressures get it.
They give it a racer. I love shot blockers. They add such a dimension to your team.
Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nessler. We got a good one going. Number 20 picks up the foul. Here's a flash from the post up high. Tough spot defensively in the post, but he got the steal.
Wow, I could have made that steal. He telegraphed that. He was the Marconi guy. What a poor pass.
They're set to throw it in from the side. He keeps the dribble as they reset. Takes the pass in the paint. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Whole team that's on the floor is quick. But so's the defense, and they do a nice job. Oh. looking for a good shot. Reverses the ball after having a guy in the post. Way off target. He stole the ball. Great pressure there.
Fantastic ball pressure. The pressure got to the ball handler, and he lost it.
The power forward with the ball. Tries for two. I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
Call this a one-man show, Brad. I don't know if it's a good thing or a bad thing.
Takes care of the ball until the offense resets. The power forward gets the ball. His shot blocked from behind.
He set him up nicely.
Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc, looking for the open jumper.
Great pressure, great double team. Really explosive.
Goes up for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Small forward gets the pass.
Pressure that basketball. Help one another. Communicate.
Bounces off. Number 33 takes it away.
There's a steal.
Doesn't go. Entry pass in the paint, and he'll kick it back outside. For the bucket, can't get the shot to go. He'll regroup the offense.
Up it inside.
Takes the pass in the paint. They move it into the front court. Number 20 comes up with it. Both teams are looking to get something going here. Fakes a jumper.
Very soft defensively. No pressure on a basketball.
And with that, there's going to be some open jumpers if they don't pick up defensively. On the dribble, gives it up. Let's watch the move as he works his man and out a fadeaway jumper. Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us. Erin?
Well, Brad and Dick, how about this crowd? They're enjoying this close matchup, and there's nothing better than a close game during tournament time.
Thanks, Erin. With a stop here, there will be sheer pandemonium in the stand.
Got to think right now. Got to focus defensively.
How do you keep the man sealed on that double team, Dick?
Not like that, Brad. They really got to be active. Active hands, active feet.
The skip pass is picked off. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
Shows patience, waiting for the reset. Trying to draw some contact. Perfectly executed. He launches the bomb. Off the rim and no good. Cross court. He takes a three. I don't think that's the guy they want shooting that shot.
Yeah, that's horrible, Mr. Nestler. Horrible shot selection.
Turns it over. They'll work it around the arc. High post flashes.
He's got hops like you, man. He got hops like you.
Yeah, it is pretty similar.
Ah, I didn't realize my partner was a high rise.
With a deep shot from outside. Hofstra are doing a nice job of putting a solid run together here.
Yeah, they're really starting to put that offense.
Now they'll bring it up. Executes the baby hook. They still don't score. And he scores despite the hack. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in. Did a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Didn't give it to him down low. Going the other way. In the paint.
There's the trap.
The defender right on his hip, and I think he's holding his ground, Dick.
He's doing a great job. I tell you, doing a phenomenal job not allowing the offensive player to seal them off. Great anticipation defensively.
Shot clock is dead. Moving it around the perimeter for two. Drains it. Gave it up and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Overplays on the pass, and he did. What a facial on that one. Those are the types of plays you want a lot of. These kids are on a roll. Look at them celebrating with one another.
Hey, can you blame them, Brad? They're playing well. Hey, Brad, you want to get to the line early and often. You end up getting your opponents into foul trouble, and it's also an opportunity to get some points.
And he can't hit the shot. I don't even know if you and I can find a seat in this place, Dick.
I'll tell you one thing, you get the home court advantage when you got a crowd like this. By the way, you and I have the best seat in the house.
Way off target. At halftime, the Pride are ahead by 8. Best play of that half. Let's take another look. Penn State had a horrible first half, Dick, in turning the ball over.
I see a lot of guys out there thinking too much when they have the ball. When you think too much on a basketball court, they're trying to be Aristotle, man. They got to be basketball players. The opposition has time to react. You can't let them have that advantage.
Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, as we know, this is it. Now, I could hear from both teams' huddles the excitement. They are ready to play and leave it all out on the floor. This is going to be an exciting second half.
All right, thanks, Aaron. The point guard takes the pass.
High post screen, going to use it.
The point guard handles the feed. Working it around the perimeter. He launches the bomb. There was no doubt about that one.
That's a nice looking play right here.
The point guard receives the ball. Controlling the ball. Number 11 is charged with the foul. Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
Looking for a good shot. Defense! Working around the perimeter. Defense! He shoots. He gets the bucket. Number two, pump fakes. Tries for two, and he misses. Pulls the trigger. Good. He can't stay with it.
He's got to get some help from his teammates on D.
Puts it on the floor and up and under. Doesn't go. The point guard receives the pass.
The pressure's getting to him, Brad.
With a jump hook and off the mark. The point guard handles the pass. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man. Nice job of using the screen to get open for that good shot.
On the dribble, gives it up. Great defense. The offensive guy now is gaining position down there on the low block, Dick.
I tell you, he gained big-time position by getting the good angle, the good arm entry, had the real extension.
Dick, how's that backcourt comparison shaping up, do you think?
Hey, Brad, that's a question that these coaches should be asking themselves. How can they, as coaches, get the most out of their guards? Are they quick enough to pressure the opponent, or offensively, can they create off the dribble? To me, it's about finding the weaknesses and attacking them.
Momentary look from three-point land. Launches away.
He got his jumper off by running that defender into the screen.
Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. A defensive player beats him to the spot.
He shoots from the top of the key. They really seem to be letting this one get away, Dick.
Yeah, there's been a breakdown somewhere. They need to talk this one over, Brad.
Dick, they're doing a great job defensively down there in the low block.
I tell you, what a great job by the defensive player. He's winning the battle on the interior because he's beating him to the spot.
Number 15 takes the pass in the paint. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
That's seven unanswered.
Pump fakes. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
The Nittany Lions have found a player who cannot seem to miss, Dick.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple.
Number 45 with the fake.
Tempo to game, really important here. You want to establish some good tempo.
They get out on the break. With a bucket and in and out. Boy, it's all elbows and shoulders down there, and I think the defense is winning, Dick.
I tell you, doing a great job in post defense. A lot of people don't realize that is an area that has to be taught, and this kid has responded in a positive way.
He launches a three, makes it. They work the perimeter. He shoots from the angle. Off the rim and no good. Now they work it around the perimeter. Number 13 is fired up right now, emotional.
I love seeing players play with emotion and passion. There's absolutely nothing wrong with that.
And there's a lazy pass. It's stolen away. Turnover. Will it turn into two the other way? That spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job by the defense not allowing them to make that turn.
For two.
I did a great job getting post position. Hey, Brad, that shot's impossible to stop. It's unbelievable. It's not utilized enough.
Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Brad and Dick, what a turn of events down here on the sidelines. The coaches and the players, they are feeling the heat, the message from the bench, defensive stops, and do it now.
Look at that spacing.
On the dribble, gives it up. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
He throws it up from downtown. That's an ill-advised shot.
That shot was definitely ill-advised. The frustration right there.
Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket, not quick enough. And a great reaction by the defensive post player.
He'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in. Did a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Number 12 gets his first minute.
Very strategic substitution, Brad. Good decision by the coach.
First shot, good. Makes both of them. For the bomb.
Man, he ran his man right into the screen to get off that nice jumper.
Top of the circle, rims out.
See, that's what I like, a good rebound. Too many players these days want to score and do all the fancy stuff. Rebounding doesn't get you on SportsCenter, but it helps your team win.
Dick, they really need to get something going in a hurry here.
Yeah, call a timeout and get your boys into the game, Brad.
This one could be over.
It sure is, Brad. They have no chance of getting back into this one.
Stolen. Gave it up. It's stolen.
Nobody got back. Defensively, rotation was very poor.
Trying to draw the foul.
That was really a nonchalant pass. Get that sucker out of the game, man.
To the action. Working it around the perimeter. From the baseline. The Nittany Lions have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
Daddy's on fire.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. You're 15 to 17 feet apart.
For two. He gets it to fall. Sure they'll continue to look to foul here, Dick.
They have to foul in order to stop the clock, Brad.
And again, let's take a look at that State Farm drive of the game, Dick.
Hey, the ability to get to the paint is one thing, Brad, but he also demonstrated the ability to finish as well. That's awesome, baby, with a capital A.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock. Points off turnovers, Dick, a stat I know coaches pay a lot of attention to.
Hey, Brad, it sure is. You want to limit your opponent's number of points off turnovers. Ultimately, you want to nullify the easy basket.
As we take a look here at our backcourt production.
Hey, Brad, I'll tell you one thing. Productivity from the backcourt is a must. You must initiate the offense, distribute the ball, and score. These are all things that you rely on your backcourt to do.
Hits that one. second one is good.
Dick, they're really getting it done from the line tonight, aren't they?
And a surprisingly collective effort, Brad.
Looking for a good shot. He puts it up. Off the rim and no good. He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot. They still don't score. Tries for two. Rims out.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Playing for the steal in the post, and he didn't get it.
I'll tell you, tried to make the spectacular play, but now he's embarrassed.
Oh, he's agitating his opponent now.
That could be a poor move on his part. He's thwarting the opponent.
Dick, I think the better team won, we can say that, and it's heartbreak for the other club, but, you know, you got to win it, keep on going to get to that final Monday night in April.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball, they made sure they converted on the free throw line, they did all the little intangibles we talked about, and that was the difference in the game.
Hofstra is on their way to the Sweet 16 now after dispatching both their first two foes.
I tell you, Brad, these young men are bringing their A game, and their third-round opponents better be prepared because these kids are looking to go all the way, baby.